we need to take more time to disquiet our soul and go away from the noise in this world and find that spirit that's drowning in us, and just listen to finally to that spirit again that was hungry to come out. I didn't hear a voice condemning me. I didn't hear a voice pushing me further. Yeah. No, it was a voice that was telling me, you're a beautiful creation. You're a child of this wonderful creator who loves you passionately. It's a ridiculous love. How does he love me? Why? And then you search and you seek what it is that the spirit is speaking. And then you find God. This finding God is in spirit. It's not in the body, the mind. It's not the mind that finds God. It's not the body that finds God. It's the spirit. And once you find it, then your mind comes to an understanding. Your mind comes to receive that peace. Your body gets comforted. Your body gets nurtured. And all that. So, you know, it's sort of like just flipping everything around from a worldly, physical, mental, emotional kind of world. You know, your spirit is down here. You have to flip it around. When you address the spirit in you and finally find your peace in your spirit, your emotion and your mental capacity and your physical is all lifted up as well. Whereas, you know, prior to my coming to know the Lord, it was my physical and my emotions and my limited human understanding that was here, and my spirit was drowning. And there was no way that I could satisfy whatever I wanted here. There was always something lacking. There was a vacuum in my life, and I couldn't figure out what it was. Until I realized and I came to know that I was missing God. Our DNA has a godly DNA in us that needs to be, you know, that needs to be satisfied, that needs to have a relationship and understanding for one to be able to live a full life, a meaningful life, where you're not only running after the things that don't really mean anything, things that when you die, you can't even take it with you. You know, relationships, the love you have with your creator, and with your family, and with your friends, that relationship you take with you, you bring it with you, because it's in your spirit. I guess, and so you don't get that rest that your spirit is so hungry for. And you know, spirit is a very integral part of our existence. We have four dimensions. We have body, soul, mind, and spirit. You can't have one, two, or three and not all four. You need all four.